In Ultra, you can access tools and certain settings for a course in the Details and Actions section on the main course content page. So if you're looking for tools that may have been available in the Tool Availability menu area in Blackboard Original, this is likely where you'll find those. When you navigate to your course content page in Blackboard Ultra, on the right-hand side, you'll see the course faculty, and under that, the Details and Actions menu. Some of these items are set at the system level and might not be able to be changed, but let's take a look at the items that are available here. The first one is the roster, and if you select View Everyone in your course, the list will come up with everyone who's listed as an instructor and any students in your course as well. You can view them in this icon view or in a list view. As the instructor, you can also quickly see here what accommodations individual students have. You can set whether or not the roster is visible to students, and if you do set it as visible, students will be able to see who else is in the course, but they won't see that detail about the accommodations like you would as the instructor. To return to your course content page, click the X in the top left corner. The next item on the Details and Actions menu is the progress tracking status. From this area, you can turn on or off the progress tracker, and this is essentially a way for students to mark off individual items as they navigate through the course learning modules. Students will be able to see in that Details and Actions menu whether or not progress tracking is turned on in their course. The next item is the course image. You can click Edit Display Settings to change the image that is presented at the top of your course. The next item on the list is the course availability. So here it says the course is open. If I click on Students Can Access This Course, it opens up a little pop-up where I can choose to make the course private so that students can't access it, or to complete the course so that it's still accessible to students for viewing, but they can't add content. The next item is the attendance option. The attendance tool can be added to basically mark students as present, late, excused, or absent. You can choose to add attendance to the gradebook as a part of students' grades as well, but there are some limitations on how it calculates those grades. And it's worth noting that if you add this attendance tool and mark attendance for anyone, it's not possible to really turn the tool off at this point. You can remove it from the gradebook, but the students would still see it on this Details and Actions menu and see their attendance marked. So just be aware of those before you add it to the course. The next item on the list is books and tools. If you select View Course and Institution Tools, it'll show you some of the tools that are available for the instructor and other available e-learning tools and publisher content. If you scroll down to the bottom and select Browse All Course Tools, this will actually take you out to the content market. The content market includes all of the institutional tools that are available to you, like Kaltura, Microsoft, VoiceThread, Zoom, and the publisher platforms as well. Another item toward the bottom of this list is question banks. If you have any test banks that are already loaded into your course, they'll appear for you here and you can manage them, or you can add new question banks by importing or creating them. And you can also use these as you're building out assessments in your course. And finally, the last button here is to add a course schedule. Depending on where you are in your Ultra build, you may want to do that. So you could click on Add Course Schedule and add a schedule with the name and all the details. If it's an online course, you might even add the location as the Zoom link, and then students could access that straight from the front page. If you're not ready to add that information yet, you can click Skip and add that through the calendar later.
We hope this has been a helpful introduction to some of Blackboard Ultra's tools. If you're an instructor who needs support in Ultra, contact UAA's instructional design team at uaa_design@alaska.edu. If you're a student who needs support in Ultra, contact the UAA Technical Support Center by calling 907-786-4646 or emailing uaa.techsupport@alaska.edu.